Students at Bailey's Elementary, a sustainable operations partnership school, began planting their new butterfly garden. Anne Rosenbaum, Bailey's outdoor science specialist, explains what was planted in the garden.
This one's called Blazing Star, or Leatris, or Leatris. There are people pronounce it different ways. And I just think this is a fun one. It's also a popular nectar source for butterflies. And then it's surrounded with, again, some zinnias. And then this one is an aster, which is a fall blooming plant. And there's certain butterflies that really like asters as their nectar source. All right, and this shrub is another nectar source. You can see it has these pretty flowers on here and has a nice scent to it. It's called plethora. I think another name for it is sweet shrub. So, you know, with butterflies, when they are the larva, when they're the caterpillar, they have a specific plant that's called a host plant that they eat from. The spicebush swallowtail only eats the spicebush. So those are the host plants. Mm-hmm. As an adult, okay, they need nectar sources. So that's why you have to have both of them. So this one is really our beginning of the monarch part of the garden. And in it, there are three different types of milkweed plants. We have the tropical milkweed, which is an annual, and so the tropical milkweed we will have to replace, but apparently the monarchs really love this and love to lay their eggs on that. And then we have the one that's very common around here, which is called butterfly weed. And so we planted three of those, and those will fill in. Those are perennials, and they will fill in. And then we have a third type here, which will get even bigger and has, this one happens to have pretty pink flowers on it.
Students will now get the opportunity to watch how the garden is being used by butterflies during the monarch migration to Mexico.